Yep.
Since we, we actually beat the tutorial, which was very informative.
Yeah, super informative. Like, honestly, if that wasn't there, even with me being a veteran of Dark Souls and Ninja Gaiden games, I wouldn't have been able to play this game.
Yeah.
So, I would have figured it out slowly, but...
After thousands of times of dying.
Yeah.
And getting frustrated. I'm already halfway there to thousands of times of dying, so...
Yeah. If anybody out there wants to, somebody start up a death counter.
Yeah. I would love to see my death count. Honestly.
At least we asked you to do this 2 episodes in and not 25.
Yeah, well, you gotta give it to us, because the first one is the beginning of the story.
Yeah, oh no, well, I mean, I want people to go back and retroactively go from episode 1.
Okay,
I'm just saying, at least they don't have to go through 24.
Well, at least I did not die during the tutorial. You gotta give me that
one. I mean, I feel like you technically did. Your first, like, one of the first prompts in the game was run.
Oh.
And you stood there trying to punch a guy, so...
True. Very true. This is America. We don't read.
We don't retreat from nothing. I'm not retreating. I'm just dancing.
Read. We don't read.
Oh, read. Okay. Let's go. I'm not retreating. I'm advancing in a different direction.
The dinghies.
Dinghies.
All right.
And you're now in Kirishima, a tiny island off the coast of Usuki.
Hey.
There's little in the way of usable land, with the coastline rapidly giving way to cliffs and mountains. So it's a badass little cliff village place.
Alright. I can deal with this.
I've never understood cliff villages.
So this is like a more badass Avatar.
I mean, kind of. You're not shooting fireballs.
Wasn't the one city where they went to, like, built on a cliff?
Oh, okay, yeah. Sorry, I thought you were talking about the powers thing again.
No.
Okay, yeah. And yes to what you said.
Okay.
And people who have been following this game will notice this as the alpha level. This is the first level I have ever played of this game. Not London.
Alright. What do you mean?
The alpha was this level.
The alpha?
Yeah, like a year ago. When the alpha came out on PS4, it was this entire level.
Oh, gotcha. I know what you're talking about now. Oh, what the little...
That's how shrines work for real now.
Okay.
You got menus, son.
I got skill points, son.
Yeah. You can't level up yet.
But I still got skill points.
You still got skill points.
Boons, summon visitor. Oh, you can bring other people in.
Yeah. Cool. So I could play with you.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not going
change
to.
Change Guardian Spirit? Okay.
These games are not made for multiplayer at all. So when there's two people in there, it gets stupid. You literally just run up to stuff and one guy guards while the other one backstabs.
Yeah, that seems super easy.
Yeah, hey, you already got an improved axe.
Yeah.
Or actually, never mind. That's the axe that they start you with. I forgot that they don't just give you your items.
All right, so we got Elixir and Small Spirit Stone.
Yeah, so...
So if I wanted to, I can actually go and upgrade.
You could pop that to level, but, I mean, there's no point.
Why?
Because you can just go kill something and get, like, the 100 souls you need.
Well, I'm going to end up using those later on anyways, aren't I?
But usually for more important shit.
What do you mean?
Well, they make your living weapon gauge go up. Besides just killing stuff, so you can use them in boss fights to get multiple living weapons.
Okay, that makes sense.
So before you go and fight anything, let's use your skills.
Skills?
Hit your touchpad.
Touchpad.
And then go over to learn skills.
All right.
Now you're in sword right now. I would suggest not doing that since you don't have a sword.
Yeah.
Now, just
so
scroll through
them. I have 2 skill points. Samurai skill points required. 1. Grapples an enemy who is out of key, then follows up with a powerful attack.
You want that.
Okay.
You want that real bad.
Well, I'm gonna look through real quick. Purify Yokai Realm.
Yeah,
I already have that.
Yeah, you already have that. If it shows not a bright yellow scroll like that,
okay.
Then
that means
one
it's
you
been
have.
Red.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, that's Stance,
and
Key
then,
Pulse, and Purify.
Yeah, and the gray ones you haven't unlocked yet.
Yeah. Mad Spinner.
That one's fun.
Spins your body and your axe. Ooh.
You can play a movie of it if you want to check, too.
Oh, no way.
Yeah.
All right.
That one's fun.
That seems like it would do damage.
It does big damage.
Rumbling Earth 1. Swings axe overhead, then slams into the earth.
So what you realize is those are the same command, though. So you have to choose.
Oh. You can't unlock them?
Like you can unlock. You can unlock both of them, but you can't use both of them. They're both the same command. So you're going to have to slot one of them in.
Oh, interesting.
So typically people just choose which one they want instead of burning the skill points on both, you know?
I understand.
Yeah, so that's when people's stamina bar goes out to red.
Okay.
That does huge damage.
Okay. So, and then I have this one, which is Flux 1. Changing to another stance on a successful key pulse increases the amount of key recovered.
Yeah, you get those once you're getting real good at the game.
Okay, so I'll save my last point for later.
There might be something further in the tree.
Oh, there is more. Sweet. Key Pulse Heaven. High stance only activates when you recover full key from Key Pulse.
Right.
Raises the damage caused by your next attack.
So if you do a perfect Key Pulse, your next attack does it's nearly double damage.
Okay. Key Pulse Man.
It's going to be the same thing. Heavy, medium, light version of it.
Okay. Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah.
So, I'll probably end up using the midpoint a lot, just getting used to everything. So I'll probably go...
Yeah, that one's really up to you, man.
I'm doing the man one.
Yeah, because literally, there's no... I can tell you which stance that I like more. But, there's no way to tell someone which stance is better at all. You're definitely going to use all of them.
Sweet.
So, in case you forgot how to run. That's the one thing I didn't get. It was, it taught you all that stuff again.
Yeah. I mean, I don't mind it, because, sometimes it's a good refresher.
Yeah.
It's good to have a refresher. And when you break items, does it drop items?
Sometimes it drops, gold and stuff.
Gotcha.
You can just roll through them Dark Soul style, though. You got a stone.
Yeah.
You got three stones.
Yeah.
How'd you manage to not aggro him? Holy shit.
Dude, get the hell out of here.
That was supposed to be a real tough lesson for you. You're supposed to throw a rock at that guy so the guy that was sitting there doesn't aggro, but he just never pulled for some reason.
I mean, I'm cool with that.
Right? It's just because he does huge damage.
Dodge is going to be my best friend.
Yeah, dodge and block.
Because you're my best friend. What the hell?
Break that open. You scared him.
But
why are you swinging into home?
They're swinging at
Yeah, they just get scared anytime something swings around them.
Oh, I've got to get him to a shrine.
Oh, no, you sent him to the shrine.
Oh, okay.
You sent your little Kodama buddy to the shrine.
Well, it said guide to the shrine.
Yeah, that's all it is. It's you're guiding them over to
it. Okay, so, see, that's deceiving.
It's Japanese translation. Give them some credit. Or, some leeway.
Remember, we're Americans. We don't read. All right. I guess let's continue on.
Indeed.
My wayward son.
There'll be peace when you are gone. Except apparently not.
Except not. So a lot of these are just...
Well, some of the dudes, when you run up and pick stuff up, most of them are just items later in the game.
Yeah.
But every once in a while, someone will say something.
Yeah. Hey, help me...
No, it's actually usually, them talking about their last moments.
Oh, okay. I'd gotten my head bit off by an Oni.
It's actually usually a whole lot of England that's coming in and fucking people up.
Really?
Yeah. There's a whole lot. Well, it's not English soldiers, but they're instigating a war between Lord Iyasu and Lord something or other.
I got a Kusarigami.
Yes, you did.
Sweet. Let's go ahead and equip that real quick. And let's go ahead.
Yep, and you can go ahead and check out that moveset. It's pretty cool.
Alright, let's go ahead and try it. Alright, so it's more ranged.
Yep. Well, you need to remember that key pulse, man. Yeah. Get used to doing that all the time. Yeah, its low stance is more, it's a single, target focused. And it's just pretty much knock someone's stamina way down.
What's this?
That is where somebody died. You can challenge their revenant.
I can challenge their what?
Their revenant. It's so essentially their ghost, yeah.
So if I wanted to, I can,
you can summon him and fight him. He's gonna fight with the exact same style and weapons as the guy who died. And if you beat him, you get some of the items that the guy had.
And that's a big if.
I mean, I'd heal first.
Well, yeah.
You can pull it. I would mention that you haven't leveled up yet, so I think you're level 2 or 3.
Oh, so probably not the best idea right now.
Nah. There'll be tons of other revenants for us to fight for you to get gear.
Yeah. Oh!
Oh. And you have fallen. You left your doggy.
What the hell?
You got stray beasts, son. Don't leave your back open.
I was stupid and left my back open. That is my bad. Okay, so there's more revenants.
Yeah, those are people who have died since the last time you spawned at a shrine.
So, back in London.
No. Since the beginning of this level. You used the shrine at the beginning of this level.
Oh, yeah. Huh.
But yeah, it repopulates every time you you die or use a shrine again. Yeah, actually, if you want to...
This one's a level 1.
Yeah, you can go ahead and try that out. I'd back up and just see how it fights first and see what it's using.
Okay. It's a lance.
Yeah, I just lock in until it burns its stamina. Yeah. It'll burn out its stamina pretty quick. Alright, hit it. You're out of stamina.
Well, I was also...
There you go.
Oh my lord! I accidentally let go of the button, the block button. Yeah.
Okay, so since you died again without getting back your fox, he's back now. You just don't get any of your souls.
Well, I don't think I have that many, anyways.
You have 1,000.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
It was probably a good 3 levels or something. It's not bad. Okay. Especially considering it wasn't that long of a run for you to get him.
Yeah. No. Which I can actually probably get them again, anyways.
Yeah, you'll get the exact same amount.
So let's leave the corpses alone.
Yeah, at least until you just get used to your fighting a bit.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, you don't have a backstab yet.
Oh my god.
That plan was good until you didn't block.
I was hitting the wrong button. That was my bad.
What were you hitting?
L2. Ah. For those of you who didn't hear that, L2. Not really worried about the key recharge right at this moment.
Nah, it doesn't matter when you're just swinging around and running shit. So when you see their that bar between their or below their health get red like that,
yeah,
hit them with a strong, and it staggers them. That's what the grapple is. That's where you get your big damage from.
Oh, okay, that makes sense.
So a lot of this game is you're trying to force enemies to waste their stamina, so you can just blow them up big. Tone down that guy's aggro range or something, because I remember walking up to him in the alpha, and like you'd walk up to pretty much that corner there, and then he'd instantly sprint at you.
Yeah, they had to, because if you're telling the truth, which I think you are. Oh, I forgot about you.
You're running into a problem where you're going into like your combos with no stamina.
Yeah, that's where the chi's gonna come in, or the ki.
Yeah, that ki pulse is like, it's imperative. There you go.
No, I've always been one to dodge around and then attack.
Yeah.
With really any game that you have a dodge mechanic in. Look at this guy.
There we go. Yeah, you're getting the hang of it now.
Starting to.
And you're kind of like, it's not gimp, but you're using such a limited moveset right now because you don't have any skill points.
Yeah, I'm kind of impaired right now.
Yeah.
I need to heal, though.
Well, just swap back over to your heals and just press up. That's what happens every time you kept on hitting L2 or R2.
I don't have any heals.
Yeah, you do. Hit R2. It's already on there, dude.
The elixir?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that's what that was. That's my bad.
You used it to heal a little while ago.
I thought that was something else.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
No, you're good.
What is this? It's just a grave.
Yeah, it's just a little months.
Yeah,
this is literally in case you didn't play the tutorial.
Yeah.
But you now have been getting fucked up the entire time.
Yeah. But I didn't die in the tutorial.
You didn't die in the tutorial. I'm very proud of you.
Hey. I strive for goals, and I get goals.
Not achievements, goals.
Goals.
I get them.
I get them good.
That sounds like an awful Fox show. The Goal Getter.
Oh, you mean like 24?
Yeah.
Oh, shots fired.
Pew, pew, pew. You mean like Bones?
No,
I like that show.
I like Bones.
I love that show. Although that show, like, have you watched it recently? Like, from beginning? That show is so bigoted.
Yeah.
Like, unbelievably bigoted. There's a lot of stuff that I'll sit there and watch the episodes, I'll go, oh, wow. They let you say that? Like, there was literally a scene where, the episode was entirely about, Booth and Brennan, finding a murderer in, like, a BDSM club.
Yeah.
And the entire time, Booth's freaking out about how big of freaks everyone there is and shit.
Oh my lord!
You almost had it. You're letting the panic sit in a little bit too much.
What do you mean?
See, you're backing out a lot instead of just going slightly moving. Well,
I was trying to get to where I could get one.
That's never going to happen.
Yeah. But it kind of happened.
They move at the same speed as you is the problem. So you're never going to single them out. You can kind of get them behind each other, and you can circle left and right so they're not attacking at the same time, but you'll never get them alone. Unless you can pull one with a stone. Which, if you want...
Well, that second one with the axe kind of surprised me.
Yeah.
Excuse me.
Let's use...
Pirate armor.
Hey!
Alright, I'll look at it.
So that's... It's a head armor.
It's gotta be way better than zero.
Yeah. Because, your equip rate's only at 25% right now, so...
Yeah.
You can keep on throwing on stuff for another 23-point-something% before you your dodge slows down.
Well, that was... Come on, keep going.
Yeah, so in spots like right there in between his swings, let go of that block. Because that's why you're running out of stamina a lot, too.
Oh,
you're
not releasing
your block at all.
Gotcha.
Ooh, shit. I'm surprised I didn't blow you open. When I see big windups like that, it always makes me scared to block them.
Oh, yeah. No, I understand. Oh! See, I blocked that one. It broke me open.
Yeah.
There's a piker here. Up here, around the bend.
Yes. I was waiting for you to still just get immediately hit.
Oh, no. It took a swing.
There you go. Taking that heavy. The stamina regain.
Sorry.
Well, whatever. Right. Kills it, kills. Now turn around. Go back to your shrine.
Why?
Because you have enough to level up. You might as well just dump a level in real quick.
Alright.
Get yourself some health.
I getcha.
Yeah, those medicine things they give you in the first mission aren't... I don't even know where the fuck you can get them past that first mission, actually.
The elixir?
Yeah.
Or not the ones in the tutorial mission.
The ones in the tutorial mission. I don't know where the fuck you can get them outside of there.
So level up.
Level up.
Alright, so body is... resistance to poison, paralysis, and it's life, so I'm guessing that's your HP?
Yeah, well, it's also the stat that affects spear scaling.
Spear scaling?
Yeah.
Okay. Heart is your key.
Yep.
So that's your stamina.
Yep, stamina and then swords and bow damage.
Alright. Your stamina... Okay, there's stamina.
Stamina is how much you can carry.
Oh, okay.
So if your equipment weight rate gets above 49%, your agility goes to a B rating, which means that your roll is slightly slower. If it gets to 56, or if it gets higher and higher, the lower it goes. So you can equip all heavy armor. You're just not rolling around anywhere.
I get you. Alright, so dexterity, magic, spirit, skill, and strength.
So here's something I wish they would tell you in this menu. If you want to level up your Kasurigama, you level up dex.
Gotcha. What about my axe?
Strength.
For strength?
Yeah.
That's what I thought.
Yeah, because it says axe.
Yeah. That was my first clue.
Good job.
So why not? Let's go.
Junior detectives.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, let's see. And you got a samurai skill point from them, too.
Oh. So that means I have another skill.
Yeah, well, you have two skill points that you can use.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that. Okay.
Because you had that one. Oh, you can check out what Kodama you got, too. Alright.
Let's see if Kodama is.
Kodama. You got the warrior blessing. So if you pay him 100 gold, he'll increase a drop your drop rate for
is that
armor.
Permanent?
For that level.
For that level?
Yeah.
Why not?
Yeah, 100 gold isn't shit.
Yeah.
Like, you end up getting thousands upon thousands every level, and you burn so much.
Enemies are back, huh?
Yep. It's just little things you need to learn to pay attention to, and once you got them all together, it starts to feel real good.
Yeah, I've got to add the red into the paint and the yellows.
Yeah, but you can already feel it, right? Like, it's...
Yeah. My only problem is I've not been one of a first-person shooter, so you don't get to use both your index and your middle finger together that often if you're not that much of a first-person shooter.
Yeah.
So I always use my index fingers for both left and bumper and trigger.
Now I can see that being a problem.
So that is my main problem that I'm going to have to work on, but that I've been trying to work on.
Yeah. That's a problem not just for this game. That's a problem for games in general, honestly. Because, like, there's a lot of games where you're going to need to use both triggers pretty quick.
Wow, yeah, they had to have changed it. Because you see how high I got up there?
Yeah, you got really close to him. I think it honestly was a little bit too rough, because you used to be able to throw a pebble at him, and sometimes it'd still pull the dude, which is bullshit. It kind of negated the use of the pebble.
Yeah.
Or the stone in this game.
So.
Pebbles and,
Dark Souls.
No, just Bloodborne. It's stones everywhere else. And there you go. Now you got your strength bonus for your next attack. Now that strength bonus only lasts for like a second and a half, 2 seconds.
Gotcha. So pretty much after you refill your ki, you kind of have to attack.
Yeah, burn it. If you want, I believe, instead of going up, I think you can keep on walking towards that tree. Or it might be a different zone. Yeah, it's a different zone. Never mind. I think it's further up the mountain. There's a little side path you can go off on.
I get you. I need you. I got my grave back.
Right.
There's an enemy over there. Did I go this way before?
Yeah, you did. You died. You got hit in the back by an axe, remember?
No, that was up the other way where my grave was. No, this was the problem. There was two over there.
Yeah, now you walked over, you killed one, and got hit in the back by the axe here.
Gotcha. Alright, so let's try something.
Yeah, I'm just lock. Well, lock on.
Whoa.
Yeah. Also, remember to check houses.
Okay. At least I saw him before he hit me.
Yeah. And you've now become more proficient with an axe, so you got a samurai skill point.
Oh, nice.
So the more and more you use weapons, the better you get with them. So the more damage they'll do. And also you get samurai.
Oh, they both came at me. Come at me, bro.
There you go. Now it's just cleanup duty. And like if you get an extra strike on them, you cut their head off and you cut like other limbs off their oni and stuff.
Nice. Hey, check the house.
Yeah, good job. And you got all kinds of stuffs.
Stuffs that I won't use.
Maybe the chest piece.
Yeah, the chest piece I'll use. Oh, the pants.
Or their pants. Their I thought it was a chest piece.
Ooh, yeah, 14 boost. Yeah, hell yeah.
Yeah. Now you look like a strange pirate.
Strange pirate, that's right. That's Mr. Strange Pirate to you.
Now, I forgot to tell you. We do have pre-order armor. If you wanted to throw that on.
Oh, interesting.
But it's
like probably stupid OP.
Not really. It's a full set bonus though, so you get an extra like 15% close combat damage and stuff.
Alright.
But it looks really cool. It's called the Red Warrior Sunate gear. At the very least, I'll like equip it to show you it at some point.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, you managed to ghetto out getting fall damage. That's the best kind to get damage.
Oh, hello.
There you go.
You fell right into my trap.
Aha. Ooh, an elixir.
Which I was needing. Thank you.
And it looks like your living weapon gauge is almost full.
And it looks like this guy's gonna die after I lock onto him.
Yeah, I was waiting for you to just run out of stamina and for him to backstab you.
Yeah, then I was like, nah, let's not do that. Hey, buddy. Hello. Oh, there's three.
Yeah. Yeah, this spot's a little rough.
Oh, there's four.
Yeah, spot's a little rough.
It's perfectly fine with me, because, well, there you go. No!
Getting lit up.